everyone. I'm Vladimir from Virtuozzo, and my talk is about the features that were developed around Qemu backups over the last year. So it's how all Eric presented works in Qemu. Most of work were about incremental backups, so I'll start from them, then I'll move to external backup API, which involves NBD, a protocol extension, and fleecing schemes, and then a few words about architecture and performance of backup. So incremental backup is when we copy only the data that was changed since previous backup. To achieve this in Qemu, we have dirty bitmaps, which tracks disk changes, and these bitmaps are what it all boils down to. So if we want proper incremental backup, we should maintain basic VM operations such as start and stop, so bitmaps should be persistent. We also have migration, suspend resume, snapshots, and we need external backup API, so there should be some way to export bitmaps out of the Qemu, and this way is NBD protocol extension. Then one by one, another. We have persistent bitmaps support since 2.10 version of the Qemu. Their life cycle is very simple. To create persistent bitmap, you should use qmp command block dirty bitmap add with persistent flag set to true. Then on disk loy, close bitmaps are saved into it, and on open, they are loaded. Only Qcode2 format is supported for persistent bitmaps. So that's all about it. Next, migration. All named dirty bitmaps are migrated through the migration channel if corresponding migration capability is enabled. It's dirty bitmaps capability, and it's available since 2.12 version. Post-copy approach is used, so you also should run command migrate start post-copy after migrate command. And it works like the following. We start target Qemu with empty bitmap, which tracks disk changes, and in the same time, we migrate original bitmap from source Qemu. When the migration is done, the two bitmaps are merged, and the resulting bitmap become available for other operations, for backup, for example. Then what if we don't use this migration capability? In this case, the bitmaps may be migrated too if they are persistent and if it's a migration with shared storage. In this case, bitmaps migrate through this storage. However, here is a drawback, because both storing and loading of the bitmap is done during migration downtime, and we have a lot of these bitmaps, or they are large enough. Downtime period may become too long. That is bad. Next, about snapshots. To understand how snapshots, I'll talk mostly about internal snapshots, how they differ with incremental backups. Let's think what can we do on basic snapshot operations, such as creating a snapshot and switching to snapshot. The most simple thing to do with bitmaps on snapshot creating is just do nothing. All the bitmaps are valid, we can continue tracking changes, and continue creating incremental backups. But if we switch to the snapshot, all the bitmaps became invalid. It's obvious, because all the disk may be changed. So what should we do? We can mark all bitmaps dirty, or we can drop all the bitmaps. And current behavior of Qemu is just fail switch to snapshot operation if there are some bitmaps. So the user should drop them by hand before the operation. But imagine, what if we just enable dirty bitmaps migration capability before creating an internal snapshot? In this case, all the bitmaps goes to Vim state, to the snapshot, and on switching to the snapshot, we can drop all the bitmaps and load them from Vim state. So I have a picture for it. Consider a tree of snapshots. Red point is an active state. Imagine that there was some backup points too. Then if we switch to some snapshot, we just load corresponding dirty bitmap from it, continue tracking changes, and we are able to create next incremental backup. Again, if we restore to some backup point, we just start with an empty dirty bitmap and continue tracking changes. And it's not a problem to create next incremental backup too. So we can manage a combined tree of internal snapshots and incremental backups. So they are friends. However, someone should manage this picture. Okay, next is bitmaps exporting. So a special NBD extension was developed. And in short, it looks like the following. In negotiation phase, there are two new commands, list meta context and set meta context. And with help of these commands, client selects meta context it wants to be exported in transmission phase. There are only two types of meta context available for now. It's base allocation context, which is common block status, so which blocks are allocated, which are not, and which are zero. And a special context for exporting dirty bitmaps. It looks like Qemu colon dirty bitmap colon and then exported bitmap name. And in transmission phase, client just use new command block status to get metadata corresponding to selected context and to selected region. Metadata comes in extents. So for example, for dirty bitmap context, there would be series of dirty and clear extents, filling the selected by block status command region. Next thing is QMP API for dirty bitmaps. In 2.4, we've started with a basic set of add, remove, and clear functionality. Then in 2.10, we've added persistent bitmaps and corresponding parameter for block dirty bitmap add command. And in the latest release, we have an experimental API for manipulating and exporting bitmaps. We can enable and disable bitmaps. Remember that disabled bitmap is one which doesn't track disk changes. Eric referred it as frozen. Then we can merge bitmaps, and of course there is a command to export bitmap. There is a limitation. Now we can export only one bitmap. So next. The last piece needed for external backup API is image fleeting scheme. It looks like the following. Imagine that we have running VM and active disk in it. We create a temporary Qcode image, set its backing link to the active disk, and start a special kind of backup job, backup with sync parameter set to none, which means that this backup do only copy before write operations. So when guest write something, this write is stopped, then a backup copies the data from the active disk, original data to the backup target, which is temporary image in our case, and then guest write continues. So for NBD client, temporary image looks like a kind of snapshot of active disk. Then moving to architecture. The first thing to do about backup is to move from write notifiers. It is a special hook used to stop guest write and do something on it, for example, copy data, to special filter driver, backup top, like it is already done in mirror job, and in case of a backup with parameter sync set to none, this backup only will create backup top filter driver, and this filter will do all the work. So it will do copy before write operations. There is an interesting thing about external backups in comparison with internal ones. Consider backup to remote NVD target with maybe a slow connection. So with internal backup, guest writes will hang waiting for write to the remote target on copy before write operations. And with external backup, there are no hangs because target of copy before write operations is a local temporary file. So it's fast enough. But why not use the same scheme for internal backups? So we just can run another backup job from temporary image to far target. And so it will work like external backup, and there are no hangs. Currently, this scheme isn't possible in QEMU. There are some limitations about backup jobs. However, it's not difficult to fix it. What are problems of this scheme? What are the drawbacks? The first one is that we'll have extra copy before write operations because these two backups, first one is represented by backup top filter driver. These two backups are not communicating. The first backup can do copy before write operations on data that was already copied to far target by the second backup. Another thing is extra save load operations to temporary image. Of course, it's a pay for not hanging the guest, not hanging guest writes. But imagine that at some moment there are no huge load in guest, not many writes, and maybe remote target is not very slow. So why not to copy data directly to far target on copy before write operations, like it is in normal backup, skipping writing to temporary image. And even maybe we want to continue guest write immediately after the data was read from active disk, not waiting for the write. Let's list these and other things that we can do around this scheme and around internal backups. So about guest hangs, we can use fleecing scheme as it is already described. And if it is possible in the moment, we will not wait for the write. So continue guest write immediately after data was read. The last thing to do is maybe a kind of prioritization of copy before write operations. So when copy before write operation isn't light, we may pause some other backup operations. Next thing to optimize is total number of IO operations during backup. Of course, the source of extra IO operations is writing data to the temporary image. If it's possible, we want to skip this. Another thing we can do is sharing reads between guest and backup. So if guest read some data, why not to reuse it for backup? Control-wise, if backup read something why not for the guest to reuse this data if it isn't changed since backup start? Next is the number of copy before write operations. Of course, all the difficulties in backup comes from copy before write operations, so decreasing their number is a good idea too. And there are ideas how to achieve this. First is using lazy discards. So during backup, we can just ignore discards from guest and maybe postpone them up to the end of the job. Next thing is consider the data that was already written to the temporary image. So all extra operations on this data will be definitely done. We can do nothing about it. Then we can forget about this data and just copy it at last. So we don't spend time on it, and we have a chance to copy more data before guest writes. So finally reduce number of copy before write operations. Or maybe another option, if we care about disk space occupied by temporary image, we can copy data from temporary image at first and then discard it. So it may be an option for the user to select appropriate policy. And the final thing about this is somehow predicting guest writes to copy more data before copy before write operations. It may be a kind of read ahead or something like this. And the final thing about the backup to do is, of course, optimizing copying loop itself. Now backup copies cluster by cluster. When, for example, Mirror have smarter logic, it have parallel requests of copying based on block status, and it works really faster. So the next slide is a proposed architecture how to achieve most of these things. The new thing in the picture is RAM cache. It may be implemented as a separate filter driver. So all backup reads goes to this cache, and then we write from cache to far target. So the features become available. We share read data between guest and backup, so it is in RAM cache. If RAM cache is not full, we can do copy before write operation, skipping storing and loading from temporary image. It goes through the cache. If cache is not full, we can even continue guest write immediately after the data was read into the cache. And on the, if the cache is full, some data may be natively pushed into underlying temporary image, which becomes some kind of disk cache. Of course, we can limit size of temporary image or not use it at all. We, of course, should limit size of RAM cache. So there are a lot of options, and the scheme looks promising, I think. And that's all. This is a short summary about what I've spoken. Persistence for bitmaps was done in 2.10. Migration and therefore suspend resume and snapshots support in 2.12. And in the latest release, we have a fleecing scheme. We have block status extension for NBD to export bitmaps. And we have, but still experimental API for bitmap manipulations. And backup architecture is under construction. There are my contacts. And you, if you have any questions, I'll try to answer them.
What is the behavior of snapshots currently in Qemu? When you get a snapshot and you have active bitmap on the current snapshot, what will happen?
Can you repeat? What about snapshots?
You have a top layer with active bitmap, and yes, you create a snapshot, right? You connect a new new layer, empty layer, and create a snapshot. What will be the variable? What will happen to the active bitmap?
Don't follow. If we create a snapshot, yes, and then what?
What happened to the active bitmap on the
snapshot?
On the previous.
It's up to you. When it's no, for now nothing is done by default, and nothing is done about bitmaps. They continue to track changes. But if you enable dirty bitmaps capability before creating a snapshot, because internal snapshots work through
external snapshot, I mean.
I've spoken about internal snapshots.
I'm asking about external snapshots.
About external snapshots, no, there are no VM state in external snapshots. So this way, of course, will not work for external snapshots. But for external snapshots, we can go through a persistence feature. So persistent bitmap may be natively stored into external snapshots. However, there may be some testing needed for it, but it should work. Okay. Thank you.